Hello students, myself Ganesh Beaglave, working as an assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchin Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this session of thermodynamics, we will see steam properties, first part. In this, the subtopic is temperature entropy diagram. Learning outcome. At the end of the session, students will be able to describe steam properties on temperature entropy plot. So, generally the steam is studied in the refrigeration and air conditioning. In the air conditioning, psychrometry is there where moist air is present. Also, in our thermal power plant, that is in the Rankine cycle, the steam is used as a working substance which undergoes the phase change. So for that purpose we require the temperature entropy plot. So the temperature is taken on y-axis and entropy on x-axis. So this is the temperature and this is the specific entropy. The unit of the temperature can be taken in either degree Celsius or in Kelvin, whereas the entropy, the unit is kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin. Now as we know, when the water is heated, suppose one pot is taken, in that pot the water is taken and the heat is given to this water, that is represented by QS. Initial temperature of water will be equal to surrounding, this is the assumption. So let the initial temperature of water is at state 1, which is represented on the TS plot. As we know, by thermometer we could measure the initial temperature, that is suppose T1, and the heat present in that is suppose Q, so Q by T will be the entropy. In this fashion the point 1 is represented on the temperature entropy plot. As there is a start of heat given to the water, there will be rise in the temperature without changing the phase. Now initially water is in the liquid phase, so there will be isobaric increase in the temperature. The temperature of water will go on increasing, it will go on increasing, and the pressure present over the water is atmospheric pressure, which is nothing but standard atmospheric pressure, which is P1, and as you know the standard atmospheric pressure is 1.01325 bar. And assuming the surrounding temperature as 20 degree Celsius, so this is the point at 20 degree Celsius and corresponding entropy. As the water is heated, the pressure is constant. The pressure over the surface of this water is a standard atmospheric pressure, which will remain constant. Then the type of heat taken by the water to get it heated up to highest temperature is called as sensible heat. Up to suppose point number 2, there is no change in the phase of the water. Water is in the liquid phase. And consider the maximum temperature without phase change is point number 2. Now what happens if we still continue heating the water beyond the point number 2? Beyond point number 2, then there will be start of evaporation, such type of vapors will be generated from the water, and the change in the phase from water to vapor will occur at constant temperature. So there is a deflection. This process will get deflected and the temperature remains same. Continuation of heating the water will increase the rate of steam generation. It will continue till 100% water gets converted into steam. Suppose this is the pot, suppose this is the pot in which only now vapor is present, that is represented by the state 3, that is represented by the state 3. So this type of energy or the heating process is called latent heat process. The latent heat and the sensible heat. Remember, in the sensible heat there is no phase change, whereas in the latent heat there is phase change. Point number 2 is called saturated vapor. State 2 is called saturated liquid point, whereas state 3 is called saturated vapor state. So can you think over the one property that will give us the range between 0 to 1? As you have studied in the FI, first year of engineering, try to recall that property. I will cover that in the coming points. Now, point number 2 is saturated liquid, point number 3 is saturated vapor. Okay, now if we further continue heating of water, then the vapors are there, 100% vapors are there, so their temperature will continue increasing up to infinity. We can heat the vapor up to infinite temperature. It may be 1000 degrees Celsius, 2000 degrees Celsius. Okay, that's why water vapors are more dangerous for human beings, okay, whose exposure is to be avoided. That's why in the steam power plant the cycle is a closed cycle, isn't it? Now the type of the heat which is required to suppose heat the water up to point number 4 is once again the sensible heat. Now the formula is very simple for sensible heat. It is mcp delta t, okay, and here also mcp delta t. So you could calculate the heat required during process 1 to 2 for heating the water from state 1 to state 2 is mass of water into specific heat of the water in the bracket T2 minus T1. Keep in mind, it will make the thermodynamics, study of thermodynamics, very simple, as this was the sensible heat process. Now heat required to convert the saturated liquid into saturated vapor is during process 2 to 3, which is nothing but latent heat process, and the formula is mass flow rate of water into HFG, where HFG is the latent heat to convert the fluid into the gas. Now this process, that is 1 to 2, was at constant pressure, isobaric pressure. What will happen if we try increasing the pressure? If we increase the pressure above the water surface, suppose from 1 bar to suppose 5 bar. Then I could draw the isobaric line. I could draw the isobaric line at 5 bar. At 5 bar pressure. So what has happened? Suppose this is 1 dash, 2 dash, this is 3 dash, and suppose this is the 4 dash. You will find that this HFG has decreased. And if I try to join all these points, then I will be getting such type of saturated liquid curve and saturated vapor curve. And this point is called critical point. Think over the critical point's latent heat. Yes, you are correct. So at critical point, the HFG is equal to 0. Okay, we'll continue further study in next session. For more study, you can refer Fundamentals of Thermodynamics by Boranke and Sontag. Also, second book, Fundamentals of Engineering Thermodynamics by Moran and Shapiro.